Hi everyone. Today in this video I am going to solve the expressions of tangential velocity, normal velocity, tangential acceleration and normal acceleration. So let's get started. Today we are going to study about the tangential and normal velocities. So before starting this tangential normal velocities, just you draw the figure. So I will explain the figure. Let us say there is a curve. Let at time t and t plus delta t, at time t, let the position of the particle is at point A, at time t the position of the particle is at point B, and at time t plus delta t the position of the particle is Q. Just you can draw or join PQ. So here PQ is nothing but chord. PQ is nothing but chord, and PQ is nothing but arc also. PQ is nothing but arc. Let us say peak arc is delta S. Arc is delta S. And AP is equal to S, then AQ is equal to S plus delta S, and say chord PQ is equal to delta C. So here I will write chord PQ is equal to delta C, and arc PQ is equal to delta S. Now you have to draw a tangent to the curve at point P and Q. The tangent to the curve at point P makes an angle psi with the positive direction of x axis, and the tangent at point Q, which makes an angle psi plus delta psi with the positive direction of the x axis. So this is Y and this is O. Draw QM perpendicular to the tangent at point P. Let the positions of the particle, at time t, comma t plus delta t, b at point p and q. Then arc PQ is equal to arc PQ is equal to delta S. Chord PQ is equal to chord PQ is equal to delta C. Arc AP is equal to S. Arc AP is equal to S, and arc AQ is equal to S plus delta S. Therefore, arc PQ is equal to delta S. Draw the tangents to the curve. At point P and Q. Which makes an angle psi psi and psi plus delta psi, which makes an angle psi and psi plus delta psi. Draw QM perpendicular to tangent PT. Now from figure what is called PQ divided by arc PQ? Called PQ divided by arc PQ as limit Q approaches to P. So now see here, this is the curve, point is Q and this point is P, and this is the chord PQ. As this Q approaches to P, this chord distance goes on decreasing. As this Q, when point Q approaches to P, this is the chord. When point Q comes here, this is the chord. So the distance of the chord goes on decreasing. So therefore, the arc PQ also goes on decreasing. So therefore, it tends to 1. When the point Q coincide exactly at point P, then chord PQ divided by arc PQ tends to 1. That implies as limit Q tends to P, delta C divided by delta S approaches to 1. And remember, as Q approaches to P, delta T tends to 0. As Q tends to P, delta T tends to 0. Now, tangential velocity. Now, heading tangential velocity. What is the definition of tangential velocity? Limit delta T tends to 0, displacement along tangent at P divided by delta T, and this is equal to limit delta T tends to 0. What is the displacement along tangent? From figure the displacement along tangent is equal to P. This is the displacement along tangent. So PM divided by delta T divided by delta T. Now we have to find the value for PM. From figure, if you draw a right angled triangle, okay, this value is equal to M, and this value is equal to P. Angle is equal to delta psi. Then what is this Pm. Pm is nothing. What is the value of cos alpha? Here I will take angle alpha. I will take angle alpha. Then cos alpha is equal to adjacent divided by hypotenuse. Adjacent is PM divided by hypotenuse is PQ. So I will write here cos alpha is equal to PM into PM is equal to PQ into cos alpha. But what is the value for PM? PM write as it is. PQ, PQ is nothing but actually it is chord PQ. It is chord PQ. And what is the value for chord PQ? That is delta C. So I will write here cos alpha. Cos alpha is equal to PM divided by chord PQ, and chord PQ value is equal to delta C. So PM is equal to delta C into cos alpha. So that is equal to, this is equal to limit delta T tends to 0. PM value is equal to delta C into cos alpha divided by delta T. This is equal to, you can write it as limit delta T tends to 0 delta C divided by delta T into limit delta T tends to 0 cos alpha. As delta T tends to 0, angle goes on decreasing, so alpha tends to 0. And if you substitute 0, you will get, that is limit delta T tends to 0 delta C divided by delta T. Delta C divided by delta T into cos 0. And what is cos 0? Cos 0 is equal to 1. So we can write only limit delta T tends to 0. Delta C by delta T into 1. Because cos 0 is equal to 1. So that is limit, or I will write cos 0. And cos 0 value is equal to 1. So this is equal to limit delta T tends to 0 delta C divided by delta T. Now I will make an adjustment with respect to delta S. So we can write it as limit delta T tends to 0 delta C divided by delta S into delta S divided by delta T. And this is equal to, so as we know that the chord, as limit, as Q approaches to P, limit Q up tends to P delta C by delta S is equal to 1. So here this value tends to 1. So we are left with limit delta T tends to 0 delta S divided by delta T. And this standard limit is equal to DS divided by DT. And this is equal to S dot. So tangential velocity is equal to S dot. Now we have to find the normal velocity. I will write normal velocity. velocity is equal to limit delta t tends to 0, limit delta t tends to 0, displacement along normal at point P divided by delta T, and this is equal to limit delta T tends to 0. Now if you go through the figure, you will get QM divided by delta T. Now we have to find the value for this QM. Actually, this is a right angled triangle. Where this is P, Q, and this is M. Now what is angle alpha? Sine alpha is equal to opposite divided by hypotenuse. And PQ is nothing but here chord PQ. So QM is equal to chord PQ into sine alpha. And what is chord PQ value? Chord PQ value delta C into sine alpha. So this is equal to limit delta T tends to 0, QM value is equal to delta C into sine alpha divided by delta T. Now what is the value for sine alpha? As delta T tends to 0, the value of sine alpha is equal to 0. So first I will make here separate terms. Limit delta T tends to 0, delta C divided by delta T into limit as delta T tends to 0 sine alpha, and this value is equal to sine 0 or sine alpha divided by alpha into alpha. So sine alpha by alpha is equal to standard limit 1 into alpha. Alpha value is equal to 0 means you will get 0, or directly you can write sine 0 is equal to 0. So here we are left with limit delta T tends to 0, delta C divided by delta T into 0, because sine 0, as delta T tends to 0, alpha tends to 0, so sine 0 is equal to 0 only, and total its value is equal to 0. So normal velocity is also equal to 0. So today I am going to explain tangential and normal expressions. So you have to draw the figure as shown here. Let P be the position of the particle at time t, and Q be the position of the particle at time t plus delta t. That is, you have to draw the tangents to the curve at point P, which makes an angle psi. And at point Q, you have to draw the tangent, which makes an angle psi plus delta psi. At point P, you have to draw a normal. Then the angle between the two tangents is equal to delta psi. Let P be the position of the particle at time t with velocity v, and Q be the position of the particle at point Q with velocity v plus delta v. So I will write here, let P and Q be the position of the particle, be the positions of the particles of the particles at time t and t plus delta t respectively. Let the tangents at P and Q makes an angle psi plus delta psi with x axis. Let V and V plus delta V be the velocities of the particle P and Q respectively. Now, tangential acceleration. Tangential acceleration is equal to limit delta t tends to 0. Change in velocity along the tangent at P divided by delta T is equal to. Now, what is the change in velocity? That is, limit delta T tends to 0. Change in velocity means, actually there are two components for a velocity. Let us say V is the initial velocity. So change in velocity is nothing but, I will write here, final velocity minus initial velocity with respect to time means it is delta T. Now we have to write down the final velocity. What is final velocity? Actually, there are two components for a velocity. Say this is a velocity V plus delta V. Now there are two components. This is the first component of the velocity, that is along, and this is the second one, that is perpendicular. So along means you can apply cos. Here angle is equal to delta psi, so that is delta psi with respect to the velocity. V plus delta V means this is delta V, so this is along. And with perpendicular means we can write it as V plus delta V into sine delta psi, so this is perpendicular to the velocity. So therefore there are two components. Along means you can write cos, and perpendicular means you can write sine. So this is the final velocity with respect to velocity V plus delta V. So final velocity is equal to V plus delta V into cos delta psi, and initial velocity is equal to V, because along the tangent at point P, divided by delta and this is equal to, now you have to substitute, this is equal to limit, you can write here V into, that is cos 0 also angle. So now limit delta t tends to 0 V plus delta V into cos delta psi, as delta t tends to 0 delta psi tends to 0. So we can write it as V plus delta V into cos 0 minus V into, this is 1 divided by delta t. This is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 V plus delta V, V plus delta V, and cos 0 is also equal to 1. So remaining term is V into 1 is V divided by delta t, where this plus V and minus V get cancels. So now this is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta V divided by delta t. And now substitute, this is a standard limit, that is equal to dv by dt. This is a standard limit dv divided by dt. This is tangential acceleration. Tangential acceleration. Now the same term we can also write it as d divided by dt of, what is v? V is nothing but velocity, and velocity is given by ds divided by dt. So d by dt of ds by dt is d square s divided by dt square. D square s divided by dt square, and this is nothing but, we can simply write it as s double dot also. Also here limit delta t tends to 0 delta v divided by delta t, we can also write it as, this is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta v divided by delta s into delta s divided by delta t, and is equal to, this is a standard limit dv divided by ds into limit delta t tends to 0 ds delta s by delta t is ds by dt. But what is ds by dt? Ds by dt is velocity. So therefore v into dv divided by ds. This is also tangential acceleration. Now similarly, we have to write down the value for the normal acceleration. Now I will write normal acceleration. Normal acceleration. Normal acceleration. Limit delta t tends to 0, that is change in velocity along the normal at P divided by delta t, and this is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 final velocity minus initial velocity divided by delta t, and this is equal to limit delta t tends to 0, delta t tends to 0, final velocity normal means towards the perpendicular. So I have shown in the figure that is equal to v plus delta phi into sine delta psi. This is along the perpendicular. Minus what is initial velocity towards the perpendicular, that is equal to 0, or we can also write it as 0 v into sine 0. V into sine 0, and v into sine 0 is equal to 0. So is divided by delta t is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 v plus delta v into, we have to make an adjustment, sine delta psi divided by delta psi into delta psi whole divided by delta t. This is an adjustment, because what is the limit of sine theta by theta as theta tends to 0? That is equal to 1. So as delta t tends to 0, delta psi tends to 0. So then what is limit is delta psi tends to 0 sine delta psi by delta psi. This standard limit is equal to 1. So here we are left with limit delta t tends to 0 is equal to v plus delta v into delta psi divided by delta t. Now if you simplify, you will get this is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 v into delta psi divided by delta t plus limit delta t tends to 0 delta v divided by delta t into delta psi, and this is equal to v into, this is a standard limit, delta psi by delta t, that is d psi by dt, plus here you will get dv by dt, the limit of delta psi by delta t. But as delta t tends to 0, delta psi tends to 0, so I will write here 0. And here you will get v into d psi divided by dt. Now this is equal to v into d psi by dt, we can also write it as d psi divided by ds into ds divided by dt is equal to v into, what is d psi by ds? It is the reciprocal of radius of curvature, 1 by rho, and ds by dt is equal to v, that is velocity. So total normal acceleration is equal to v square divided by rho.